thank you so much for joining me this morning for this walk in beautiful Wake downtown.
Well, thank you for having me. It is beautiful.
Just start off by telling me what you do here at Wake Forest.
Sure. So I'm a professor of neuroscience. I'm really interested in how the human brain works, how we make decisions, how we experience those choices we make, and how we learn from them.
You said how we make decisions. Mm-hmm. Tell me more about that.
One of the things we're really interested in are the neurochemicals that are fluctuating in our brain all the time. And in particular, we do work to try and measure dopamine and serotonin. We do experiments to try to see how those signals are fluctuating. As we make choices, our brain reacts to that, right, and adapts and changes, and those signals kind of guide us, right? So we try to decode all of that.
Well, the human brain is a big, big project to try to understand. How did you get interested in that?
For me, I think it started when I was quite young, late night pondering questions about how do we know what's real, right? What the experiences that we have. And then when I got into college, I was studying genetics, really interested in how biology encodes information. But then, through my general education classes, learned about philosophy and various humanities and got interested in consciousness and philosophy, right? These big questions. Got kind of bitten by that bug and wanted to study that scientifically. And so spent a lot of my career developing ways of thinking scientifically, experimentally, to try and tackle these big questions about the human mind.
Well, you mentioned some things maybe when you were young growing up. I heard maybe there's a movie, The Matrix.
Oh yeah.
That's... How does that link into this life story?
So, when I was in college, not to date me too much, but The Matrix came out, right? And I had been studying stuff in philosophy that sounded like this movie, and I'd been studying things in psychology and neuroscience that sounded like these things that they're talking about. So I saw that movie and I was just blown away. It was speaking to me, not by intentional design, but the questions that I've pursued are really well reflected in that movie.
Well, I heard you say neuroscience. Of course, you mentioned philosophy. Mm-hmm. There's an interest in the arts somewhere in there too. This Absolutely. Is really interdisciplinary that's brought you to the work that you do.
It is. My research tries to bring all these different disciplines that gives us different perspectives on these big problems. When a student comes to me who's interested in my work, I spend a lot of time asking them, what do they want to do?
Right.
Or what are they interested in? If I can understand that, and because I'm really interested in these big questions, I can find a path for them that kind of gives them a launching point, right? Keeps them excited and interested in science and the human brain. And we do a lot of fun projects that way.
This really resonates with me because our students having that opportunity, that real life, hands-on, experiential opportunity is so important. So.
Oh, I agree. That was critical for me when I was in college. I didn't know I wanted to be a scientist when I started, but I had the opportunity to get into a lab and it changed everything for me. Really that first week of getting my hands dirty in the wet lab and doing experiments, I was like, wow, this is really, really cool. And so I try to remember that, right, when I have students come in and create experiences that'll be lasting for them.
So what resources do you use to help your students learn and to help you make discoveries? Mm-hmm.
So one of the strengths at Wake is really the community of faculty and the teams that we work with. So for me, the most important resource are my collaborators. The kinds of experiments we do are really technical and really need the support of big teams. We collaborate with folks in neurosurgery, neurology, psychiatry within the School of Medicine, but then also, taking advantage of the breadth of humanities, right, across campuses and bringing questions and interests from faculty and the various disciplines there. For me, the community, right, and the connections with the different faculty and researchers is important.
When you're doing your experiments, tell me about what your research lab is like.
Something that's quite unique about my group is my collaboration with neurosurgery. We get to go into the operating room when patients are having brain surgery. Out of clinical necessity, they're awake. And we've talked to them ahead of time and they've agreed to collaborate with us. And so we can actually go into a human brain and make measurements of neurochemicals like dopamine and serotonin at temporal resolutions and speeds that we've never been able to before. before, you know, you could make these measurements on the scale of minutes to days or weeks, but now we can see it several times a second, right? And that's really important for how our brain actually works.
I'm so impressed by the discoveries your team is making and that you are making. What do you think about for the future?
It's a really exciting time for human neuroscience, neuroscience in general. But I think one of the things that's most exciting is that, you know, when we're asking these big questions about consciousness and choice, that impacts so many aspects of human society, right? The way that we make decisions in the business world, right? The way that we make decisions about legal processes. Across the board, humans are involved in all these things in our society. And so if we can understand how we make decisions, right? And how those decisions lead to our experiences, then we could really start to, you know, have an impact, not just in medicine, but more broadly.
Wow, I'm excited for that future too. And I love how you're talking about what we've referred to as neuroscience in society.
Yeah. It's a really, really exciting effort that's developing across the campuses, right? To bring together folks in the humanities who are interested in how humans operate in the world, but then also crossing campus into the School of Medicine, right? And creating these really crazy collaborations and exciting times.
I've called them radical collaborations,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, that's much better. Yeah.
I'm so excited to have had this time with you. Mm-hmm. And really appreciate the work that you're doing and how you're thinking about its next steps forward.
Well, thank you for having me, and this conversation has been wonderful.
Great, thank you.
Thank you.